for you.
Thank you.
You know, aren't you being a bit too... direct?
What do you want me to do? There's no other way to get physical powers that will actually be of use.
But still, I'm surprised at how you found a dungeon that pinpoints exactly what you want.
I don't have time to spare anymore. Things are starting to get desperate for me, too.
Then Earth will be destroyed. Why would they even consider that?
But if they can only get married if the Unlosing Ranger loses, then there should be nothing to worry about, right?
Speaking of which, if anything, they should be thanking you. Isn't that weird?
How are we supposed to solve this?
My beloved bride, my navy will be there to save you. You can rest assured as you jump into my arms.
Our mission this time better not be to get these two together.
I think that may be it.
You gotta be kidding me. How are you supposed to gain the power to defeat the last boss with that?
Don't get mad at me. You're the one who picked this. And love does have the power to become useful and physical. Love Conqueror! For example, you buy all the merchandise regardless of cost of the idol you like. That's the power of love. For example, you protect the girl you like by following her around night and day. That's the power of love.
Power of love? More like obsession.
Anyway, don't forget that the power of love is great. The power of love is necessary for the Unlosing Ranger to turn into the true Unlosing Ranger. Good for you!
People aren't from around here. You must be the Duke's henchmen. You're here to kidnap Media again.
We're really not here to kidnap her, but can you let us go see her?
Never! You dogs of the Duke! You won't lay a finger on me! Bizarro Earthlings are the embodiment of their counterpart's intrinsic values. She may seem like a snobbish reporter, but she probably has a noble soul inside her. Well, I guess she used to have it in the past, to be exact.
What do you intend to do with me? Are you going to take me to Geo? What's the relation between you two? Aren't you two lovers? Geo and I? Lovers? Are you serious? Geo is the heir to the family of the Dukedom. He's the boss character of this dungeon. I, on the other hand... I get it! It's like Romeo and Juliet with two rival aristocratic families, and you two are nurturing a forbidden love! No. I'm hardly more than a generic fodder character. Oh? Are you trying to make light of us fodder characters? We give confidence, items, and valuable experience points to new heroes. We are entrusted with that noble purpose. Without fodder characters, heroes would never take the first step in their epic adventure. I guess... I pride myself in the duty I have. I am prepared to be a fodder character for the rest of my life. That is why I cannot accept Gio's proposal for my hand in marriage.
She's such a great fodder character, right? You better be thankful as a hero.
Oh, so you're a hero? Then feel free to defeat me for some money, experience points, or items. When you put it that way, heroes are nothing but a bunch of bloodthirsty criminals.
So you have no intention of marrying Gio?
Right. I would rather fulfill my duty as a fodder character than become a boss character's bride. Maybe her excuse to marry him only if the Unlosing Ranger loses was her way of turning him down politely.
I think that's it. Well then, you should know what to do now. Show them what you're made of! Keep it up! A guy named Gio.
You want to meet Prince Gio? Fodder characters like you have no right to see him.
Fodder character? How dare you say that to me? They're enemies, all of them! Kill them all!
You.
did it!
Peasants?
Who are you again?
I am Geo Martin, 57th generation boss of this dungeon and fiancé to Media Lass.
I've never seen such a horrible split personality in my life.
All men want to act cool in front of the girl they like. It's only natural.
And are you all Media's friends? Then I shall welcome you here. A celebratory feast is in order.
We'll pass. We're just here to tell you Nidia's feelings.
Her feelings? See. So she has finally made her decision to marry me.
That's not it. She said she has no intention of marrying you. She wants to stay a fodder character for life. That's why... you should just give up trying to get her to marry you. Understand?
Come on, can't you be a bit more gentle when you say such things?
It's fine. You have to be this direct or men will never give up. That's what it said in Mommy's tabloid.
I see. Media must have been stressed about this all along. Would you please hand her this letter? This should put her mind at ease.
seem to know exactly when to give up. I guess for a prince... Here, it's supposed to be the last... Is that true? What does it say? Let me see. I love you, let's marry right now. What the hell is this? He didn't understand a thing I said. He's hopeless. Since he obviously won't listen to me, I think it's time to kill him.
Not what you should do. There's a better way to solve this. A way like a hero.
And what's that?
We'll just have to teach him the answer to the question, what is true love, right? Stay on guard! Good, good! Good for you!
You okay?
Hey!
your guard!
You got me, dude!
All right! Show him what you're made of! You did it! Good for you! Come on, man! Watch out!
He found you!
Watch out!
Let's do this! Attack!